This is the den of the Quinnipiac Bobcats, where the men's and women's teams compete in one of the nation's toughest leagues. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac Hockey, live from the TD Bank Sports Center. There's no place like it in sports.
The Quinnipiac Bobcats are the number one team in the country. They are led by goaltender Eric Hartzell. He's a senior and a Hobie Baker candidate. But in-state, an ECAC rival, the Yale Bulldogs, in town and trying to chase the Cats from the top perch. It's Yale and Quinnipiac next on Friday Night Ice. Arena in Hamden, Connecticut. Welcome to Friday Night Ice here on the NBC Sports Network. This crowd is ready to go as Quinnipiac, the number one team in the country, welcoming in the Yale Bulldogs. Hi, everybody. John Walton with you high above ringside, and welcome to Hamden, where this fan base has experienced a very special season. A top ranking in the country. That joined with already an ECAC title. Still 2 weeks to go in the regular season, but that doesn't matter. They're already celebrating that and getting ready for postseason play. Just one loss in a conference for the Yale Bulldogs. As Ken Hodge joins us here, it's a different story entirely. They are in fifth right now in ECAC. To get to the top four and get that bye, they need some wins, and they need to do it on offense. They've had a tough time of it of late.
They had. The last four games, they've lost all four games. They got five power play goals in those four games. They really need that top line to really step up. Agostino, Miller, Lagunier, all three of those guys have 12 goals on the season each. They need those guys down the stretch if Keith Lane's team is going to catch one of those top four spots and have that home ice in that first round.
Now, Quinnipiac didn't get to be the number one team in the country without a whole lot of strengths. They've got outstanding goaltending. They have great defense and a very balanced scoring attack. Jeremy Langlois, right at the top of that list. He's been sensational for Rand Peckgoldstein.
Leads the team in scoring with 26 points on the season. He's the guy that makes this motor run for this hockey club. He's the best defensive center Pecknold's had in his time here at Quinnipiac. Watch for him to be on the ice a lot when that Miller line is on the ice, especially.
The Nutmeg State with a big college hockey rivalry. The Yale Bulldogs, they're only 11 miles away. They're at Quinnipiac tonight and trying to pick up some standings points in the ECAC. More from the Nutmeg State next. The Yale Bulldogs are on the road in need of standings points, and they're in a tough place to find it at High Point Solutions Arena against the top-ranked Quinnipiac Bobcats. Earlier, Ken Hodge caught up with the head coach of the Bobcats, Rand Pecknold.
Coach, you clinch a Clery Cup. How do you keep your team focused on the task at hand?
Well, we've had a lot of great accomplishments this year. The Clery Cup, obviously, is something we were striving for. We've moved up the polls all year long, got in the number one ranking. We've had the 21-game unbeaten streak. So, we're just going to keep doing what we've been doing all year long, is just stay focused. It's a great group of guys, great character in that locker room. They have fun coming to the rink every day, and they're hungry, and we're not going to change anything right now.
You've played Yale once before. Tell me how you beat Yale tonight.
Well, the first thing, we've got to control our emotions. The last game we came out, we took a lot of bad penalties early, got down 2-0 before you could shake a stick at it. They were just dominating us early, and we called timeout, kind of settled the troops, and we got after it, went to work. I think tonight we just got to keep the game simple, play our system, dictate the game, play our way, and we'll be good to go.
Coach, thanks a lot. Best of luck.
Okay, thank you.
Mike Dalhousen and the Quinnipiac Bobcats, the top-ranked team in the country, the Yale Bulldogs and Ryan Obakowski. They're plus-minus leaders on their respective teams. A lot of good things happen when they're out there. Puck drop coming up. Here in Southern Connecticut, the Quinnipiac Bobcats and their rocket Marcus Studenbody ready to see this one. The number one team in the country against the Yale Bulldogs. Not too shabby at number 13. The Bulldogs have lost four in a row. They're trying to rebound on the road. And, Ken, they're trying to do it with goaltender Connor Wilson. Their number one, Jeff Malcolm, he's not available. He's hurt. They haven't played well without him.
He's been out the last four games, and that's obviously a big factor for the Yale Bulldogs. They really need to get a consistent goaltender in the net down the stretch here.
Connor Wilson, a native of Cary, North Carolina. At the other end, he's a candidate for the Hobie Baker Award. He's Eric Hartzell. The record and the goals against average pretty much speak for themselves.
Not too shabby, right? 22 wins the season, one under a goal and a half. Goals against average, not too bad.
He is the heart and soul of this team. You and I talked with Rand Pechnold before the game about what he means to this team. He's a leader, and he's become one during his time here in Hamden.
Yeah, he said, you know, he came in a little bit a cocky attitude, but he had to straighten that out early on in his career, and since the sophomore junior year, he's really taken off in the right way.
Keith Allain, a former Yale goaltender in his seventh season at the helm of his alma mater, and we are underway here in Hamden. Not, but Quinnipiac out of the zone. Matthew Peck left side, and here come the Bobcats into the Bulldog zone. A shot, they score! Quinnipiac up 1-0.
I'm going to be very interested to see if this goes to replay. It looked like Davies made some contact with Wilson as he went to the net. Pekka gets that shot as he came across down that left wing side, top the faceoff circles. As you see, he can get the puck here. He cuts across the top of the circles, goes. There is a little bit of contact right there with Davies. No replay though, and this puck is going to sneak in behind him. And Quinnipiac gets the first goal and gets all the momentum going in their direction.
Matthew Pekka scoring his 10th goal of the season. A quick geography lesson for you here. These two schools, Ken, they're not separated by a whole lot.
No, 11 miles. Took that drive up today from New Haven as well, and a little bit of traffic, but you get here anyway. Quinnipiac really believes this is going to be a good rivalry as this rivalry continues to blossom. Keith Lane's done a good job with his program, and so has Rand Pechnold with his program as well.
A little adversity, maybe for the first time tonight.
I think Miller didn't see that pass coming until it was too late. He almost fanned on the opportunity. He was all by himself right down the slot area when he got that pass. Real nice job. Again, second line coming right back off the TV timeout. Got that puck right back in the offensive zone. You got the Langenier line, and then you got the Miller line.
Puck forced away by Kellen Jones, his brother with him, a shot, he scores! Kellen Jones, 2-0 Bobcats!
Turnover by Yale in their defensive zone. Killen has the puck, he's going to bring the puck out in the neutral zone. He fails to make the pass up, turns the puck over, and Jones just picks his pocket. Kellen Jones picks his pocket down the right wing side. 2-on-1 to the net. He goes blocker side low. The really difficult place for the goaltender to make a save on it. Pucks in the back of the net, and Quinnipiac takes advantage of a turnover in the defensive zone of Yale.
The seventh goal of the year for the junior, 5'10", 175 out of Montrose, British Columbia. 16:04, Quinnipiac with a 2-0 lead. Matthew Pekka into the left corner is hit by the defender, and puck down to Jones again. Alfred Barron left faceoff dot and crossed himself up and needing some assistance. Weber couldn't clear and falling down. A shot from Barron, still loose in front. Up chip to the backhand, he scores! 3-0 Cats, they pounce again.
That's going to be St. Dennis who's going to end up getting the ultimate goal here. And I think Keith Link, if it's not more than 3 minutes left, maybe call this timeout here. But a good job initially by Barron to move in on the play and get to a loose puck. And what do? You throw it back down to the front of the net. That's the most dangerous area. You got one whack at it by Jones, and then St. Dennis jumps in with the loose puck. He's got a fallen goaltender. You got to get the puck up. Exactly what he did. Got the puck up over the goaltender, and 3-0. This is not the start that Yale wanted early on in this hockey game.
Two goals in 47 seconds, and that the sixth of the year for Travis St. Dennis. Aren't a secret anymore. As the puck for Jones, empty net, he scores! Connor Jones sealing the deal for the Bobcats.
good job of getting to a loose puck, outworking his man as that puck is just chipped up the boards in the defensive zone into the neutral zone. A little bit of a slight tug on Ruffalo as his puck comes to him. He gets around him. Ruffalo falls down, and he's not going to miss those. Empty net goal, top of the faceoff circles on down. Nobody's going to miss that. He made no mistake, put it in the open net.
4-1 Bobcats. Quinnipiac will indeed hold on to that number one ranking heading into senior night here tomorrow. Day with a puck right wing for Ward into the corner. Quinnipiac remains number one. A 4-1 win and a skirmish at the conclusion. This was a fun one here in Hamden tonight. A 4-1 final. Coming up next, it's the second half of our Friday Night Ice doubleheader. North Dakota taking on Denver in a matchup of top 10 programs. The final score tonight, 4-1, the Bobcats over the Bulldogs. We now take you to Steve Schlanger and Brian Engblom at Magnus Arena in Denver. Gentlemen.
College basketball is played at the highest level, where threes fall like rain and tomahawk dunks are an official stat, where picks find their roles, gives their goes, alleys their oops. This is the den of the Quinnipiac Bobcats, where the men's and women's teams polish their moves for the big dance. Get your tickets at QuinnipiacBobcats.com. Quinnipiac basketball live from...